How to increase red blood cell magnesium content. Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
Deanna Doroshenko's second question is red blood cell magnesium. How to increase magnesium red blood cell levels? My recent test has it at 3.8. Optimal level is 4 to 6.4. I've been taking magnesium citrate supplements for a few months now, and it doesn't seem to help. I also eat greens regularly, spinach and kale. So what else can I do to increase red blood cell magnesium level, or what type of magnesium supplement should I try? Well, the first thing you want to do is look at your serum levels. And if your serum levels are low, you want to look at your urinary levels. And if your serum levels are not low, or especially if your serum levels are high, then you want to focus on promoting magnesium absorption into the cell. If your serum levels are low, then you probably don't want to focus on that. You want to focus on magnesium intake or retention or absorption. And if your urinary levels are high, you want to focus on reducing urinary loss, which might come down to stress, excess water intake. There are some genetic polymorphisms that are relevant. And of course, if you have any, if you have any kind of disorder like diabetes or something that's causing excess urinary loss, if you want to look at those things. But let's assume that the serum levels are high or normal. If the serum levels are high, you want to cut back on the magnesium supplementation. Otherwise, you're going to give yourself hypermagnesemia, which is absolutely a problem regardless of your red blood cell magnesium levels. Your serum levels are normal. You don't need to cut back on the magnesium. Regardless of whether the serum is high or normal, you do want to focus. If the serum's not low with urine high, then you want to focus on getting magnesium into the cell, regardless of whether the serum is high or medium or normal. And in that case, the top things that I would be thinking about would be insulin, salt, and vitamin B6. I don't know why vitamin B6 increases magnesium absorption into red blood cells, but it does. So 25 to 50 milligrams of pyridoxal phosphate. And then salt, salt in your food to taste, but maybe take more salt. If you're salting your food to taste and you don't have high blood pressure or edema, and salt doesn't give you headaches, but you can't bear to eat more salt because of the taste, then I would suggest getting LMNT, the electrolyte powder. This is salt that has a very sweet taste from stevia and is like fruity flavored. Much easier to get that down in large amounts if you have sort of hit your taste threshold for salt. If the salt gives you headaches, cut back on it. If the salt gives you high blood pressure, cut back on it. If the salt gives you edema, cut back on it. But if you don't have those problems, try upping the salt up to potentially 5 to 6 grams of sodium per day. Not sodium chloride, 5 or 6 grams of sodium. Don't go all the way up there, but increase it slowly. And then insulin, you want insulin sensitivity and you want insulin, right? So if you're on a low-carb diet, you might not be getting enough insulin. But if you're overweight or if you have a low-quality diet or you know you have prediabetes or diabetes, you have an insulin sensitivity issue. And so normalizing your body composition to a healthy level, making sure all your protected nutrients are in the right place, and there are many involved in insulin sensitivity, and then also getting the insulin in the form of healthy carbohydrates are all what you want to do to work on insulin. So just sum that up, you could, you're basically looking at problem is red blood cells are, red blood cell magnesium is low, magnesium supplementation doesn't work. Algorithm is first look at serum magnesium. If serum magnesium is low, look at urine. If urine, urinary magnesium is high and serum magnesium is low, you want to focus on retaining magnesium in the body. And if serum level is normal or high, you don't need to look at the urinary level. If it's high, you need to cut back on the magnesium. If it's normal, you don't. If it's normal or high, regardless, you need to focus on magnesium getting into the cells. And for focusing on getting into the cells, you're looking at insulin sensitivity, insulin stimulation, vitamin B6, and salt. For urinary loss, you're looking at anything that causes too much urinary output, stress, and if you still can't find the answer, you might want to start looking at certain genetic polymorphisms that we can go to. Okay, I hope, Deanna, I hope that answers your question. Thank you very much for it.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. For the remainder of 2020, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.